Alright, so welcome back everybody. So for this video, I'm going to show you guys how to play Dive. So let's take a look and see how we play this game called Dive. Now one thing that this game is going to be hard to do for this how to play video is obviously it's going to be really hard to see these here because obviously they're see-through, right? And so it's going to be very difficult for me to obviously show you exactly what's on these, but we will manage somehow because the lighting is just not as bright as I'd like it to be. So in this game, there's about three different phases that you will actually play this game in. The first phase is called Program, second phase is Dive, and the third phase is Rest. And so normally, when you're playing with other players, you're going to be using these little screens here, I guess you can call them screens, to basically prevent your opponents from seeing what you're doing during the Program phase. So during the Program phase, each player is going to have one of these here. This is to indicate how far a player is going to dive down, okay? During the game, a player can dive a maximum of three levels down. Each one of these, and we're going to take one up so I can see. Each one of these is considered one depth. So you're going to try to dive down as far as you can and try to get as many of these as you can. But it's really hard to determine what is actually on those, on these, because even if you have a camera and you put your phone underneath and you try to view it from the bottom and try to look upward, it's still really hard to determine exactly what is on each one. But during the Program phase, you're going to take these air tokens here, and you're going to put them on each of these bubbles here, basically. And the object, first of all, is to determine what is on the first level. Do you think the first level is going to have a shark on it? If you think the first level is going to have a shark on it, you're going to need to be able to flip this air token or any of the other air tokens over to the shark side to indicate that you think there's a shark on the first, the first depth level of the dive. However, if you don't think there's a shark there, then you'll just keep it on this side, on the sharkless side. Now, if you get it wrong, okay, so let's say you thought there was a shark there, and you put it on this side, and then it's revealed during the dive phase, that slide thing is revealed during the dive phase, then you won't be able to continue on because you got it wrong. Yes, there was no shark there, but you still got it wrong. So that's a problem. So it doesn't matter if there's a shark there or not. If you guess wrong, if there is a shark there, then obviously you won't be able to continue on. Now, each player here is going to have one of these, and they're not going to know how many levels a player is going to go down. Like I said, you can go down a maximum of 5 levels, but you may not necessarily go down all 5 levels, because you see, when you reveal the levels of the dive, the depths of the dive as you go down, some of them are going to have certain animals on them, and those animals are going to give you some points, some points for the descent board, but only one player will claim them. And only the player who has the highest number on that dive level will claim it. And only if they got it right. Meaning they guessed that there was a shark there, and there was. Or they guessed there wasn't a shark there, and there wasn't a shark there. So that's the thing. That's how they're going to get that. They're going to get it so they can get the points right away and move up their diver. Hence my diver, they're going to be able to move it up the descent board here, basically, okay? That's what they're going to do. That's going to happen twice during the course of the game, maybe. But they're not, not necessarily always be the animal you need. So the animals you're looking for are green sea turtles, red sea turtles, and the manta ray. If you find a green sea turtle and you're the player who gets it, you get to move your diver one bubble up, basically, on the descent, on this descent board here. If you're the player who found the red sea turtle, you get to move your diver up two bubbles, basically, up on the descent board, okay? That's what's going to happen during the dive phase, okay? But if you're also, let's say there's another player, and that player is all the way up to here, he's on number 15, and you're back on number 3, for instance, and you're the player who gets the manta ray, and you're this player here, you get to move your diver all the way up to catch up to the player who's in the lead, okay? Now, there are some things where that wouldn't work out. So, this section here, the brighter side, is known as the tranquil waters, and obviously this is known as the deep waters. If the player was, like, for instance, here, and you got the manta ray, and you are still all the way over there, the farthest you're going to go is the 15th spot. The manta ray does not dive down into the deep waters. And so because it doesn't go this far down, it will not be able to help you give you points. The sea turtles will still give you points, but the manta ray won't be able to give you any points. So that's how that's going to work. So even if the player, if you got the manta ray and you're this player, even if your opponent was this high up, you're still going to go up some points at least. Now, if you're the player who is the highest up on the track, so let's say I'm right here and I get the manta ray, I get no points whatsoever because I am the highest up. If you're playing with other players, you're not going to go up to whoever's the highest, you're going to go up to the player who's basically the closest to you, as in you're the furthest up. So you're only going to go up so high depending on, you know, which players are ahead of you. That's basically how that's going to work with the manta ray. So the manta ray can give you a ton of points depending on where you are on the descent board. The red sea turtle will give you 2 points, and the green sea turtle will give you 1 point. But there's another way you can score points in this game, and that's actually going to be how many successful depths you were able to go down on your dive. How many successful? So, for instance, let's say I programmed a 5 for this one. Let's go with a 4 for that one. Let's go with a 2 for this one, a 3 for this one, and a 1 for this one. Let's just say that's how I decided to do it. Now let's go to the dive phase. Let's say that's what I'm going to do for program phase. Let's see what I get for the dive phase. So, let's see here. Where's the best way you can see this? Okay. Well, you can sort of see it, but there is a green sea turtle on this one. It's kind of hard to determine, of course. There we go. You can sort of see that that's green. So I have one green sea turtle on here. Now you might see some other animals on here, some octopus or some jellyfish or something like that, but none of those animals are there for anything but just simply to maybe confuse you. Obviously, they don't matter, so you don't have to worry about them. But you also notice that there is, I put a 5 here and I said there was no shark on the first level. I decided to put that there, and look, there is no shark. So that means I had a first success on the first depth. That means I can continue going further down. So let's take the next one. I said the next one had a shark, so let's see if I was right. I was not right. This one does not have a shark. And so because of that, then the rest of these no longer matter, because I was wrong, basically ending my dive phase. So I only had one successful dive, and I can't continue further down. If I had gotten this right, so let's just say I had gotten this right. So let's say it was a, let's just say it was a 1, and I said there was no shark there, and I thought for sure there was nothing else there of interest. I didn't think there'd be any sea turtles or manta rays, so I put the lowest number on the depth of number 2 depth, okay? Well, at least I got it right this time. No shark. Okay, let's just say that was the case. So we would move down. We would go down to the next level. And let's just say I think there's a shark on number 3. So let's see if there's a shark on number 3. Oh, what do you know? There is a shark in number 3. Unfortunately, there is no sea turtles or manta rays, so nothing else happens. But I continue going further down because I did foresee the shark that further far down. Okay, so I'm now going down to the 4th level. And there just happens to be a number 4 on this one, okay? So, I still think there's a shark on this one, so let's see if there's a shark on this one. And what do you know? There's a shark on this one too, so I got that one right as well. But you know what else? Know what else? There's also a red sea turtle here as well. That means I get some points. So, let's say I did get 1 point for that sea turtle, that green one. Now I'm getting 2 more for the red sea turtle. And that's 4 successful dives. Now the last one here, I put a 3 down, and I'm going to say there's no shark on number 5. So let's see if number 5 has no shark. Well, it does not have a shark. That means I had 5 successful depths. I had a fully successful dive all the way down as far as I could go. 5 depths this time. Awesome. So now that is the end of the dive phase for me, especially for everyone else, because technically that would be the max anyways, usually. So, then you would go to the rest phase. During the rest phase, then each player would deduce how far they were able to go down. For each one they successfully were right about, whether they got the turtles or the manta rays or not, does not matter. As long as they were correct on whether there was a shark present or not present, they would continue going down. So in this instance, I would get 5 more points. I would go up 5 more on the descent track. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's how far I'm going to go on that. So that's the second time that would happen. Now remember, originally I only got the first one right, so I would only have gone up by 1 technically because of that. Okay? Now, obviously, if you're playing with other players especially, you need to have these numbers are very important. You need to have them at certain parts for certain levels you think for sure that have a certain particular animal. Maybe you think for sure that one of these has a green sea turtle, or a red sea turtle, or a manta ray. Well, if you think one of the levels in particular has that particular animal, and you've already deduced whether it has a shark or not, then you're going to want to put your highest number on that particular depth, so that way you can beat your opponents and obviously get the particular help from the particular animal. But you also might want to stack, because if you were to do all 5 and all of your opponents were able to do all 5 and everyone exactly thought exactly the same thing, that they knew that the second level had a red sea turtle on it, they would all do a 5 and then no one would get the help from the sea turtle because it's a tie. But there are ways you could potentially break a tie. You can stack these air tokens on top of each other to increase the number that you can have. So, for instance, if I really wanted that animal, I could put another air token on this, making it 7, increasing my chances of getting one of these if it was on the exact one and I was right about no shark or shark, okay? But that would also mean I would not be able to go as far down. I could go a maximum of 5, but that necessarily means that I might not always go that far down. And of course, the farther you go down, the harder it is to figure out whether it has a shark or not. So you might not necessarily want to do that. Maybe you only want to go down 2 or 3 levels in that case. And so then you'll put your numbers on certain ones instead, you know, increasing the possibility of getting the help from that particular animal, if the animal is actually there that can help you. So you might do something like this instead and only go down 3 levels. Of course, if your opponents decide to go down more levels than you, then they will continue if they can. So that means you'll be out early, you'll get less points during the rest phase probably, but you know, just like I said, it's hard to get all 5 right. So you might just want to prepare for the first few instead of trying to do all 5. It's up to you as each individual player. But that's basically how you play the game. and the game will be over when somebody reaches number 23 on the descent board. But that does also mean that somebody could beat you if they get a higher number than 23, but 23 is how the game will end. As soon as somebody reaches 23, the game will be over after everyone collects up their points, but there might be a player who gets a few more points after the fact. That could happen. But basically, that's how the game is going to end. Now, there are some variants you can add to the game. You can add companions, and then each player would get a particular animal companion that will help them out during a particular round of the game. I won't explain how all of them work, but if you're playing with the companions variant and you're playing with this green sea turtle token, you're the only player that's going to get this green sea turtle token. The other players, they'll have another animal companion instead and have their own unique ability. So if you want to play with companions, each player is going to have their own unique ability. But for instance, the green sea turtle, you can use this like a one-time use when you assume or when you know for sure for a fact that there's a green sea turtle involved in the dive phase, and you want that sea turtle, and you think you're gonna get it, you can use this token ahead of time to basically get an extra point from the green sea turtle, which is pretty nice if, you know, you're the one that claims it, of course. That all assumes that, but, you know, it's a possibility. There's also the angler fish. Now, normally, you wouldn't be able to dive down below a maximum of 5 depths, but if you notice, looking at this angler fish here, if you flip it over, well, it's got a shark on it, okay? Which means you can use this to go down an extra level, meaning you can go down to a 6th level. So you, if you're planning on doing all 5 of these air tokens on one particular one, you can be the player that can go down once. And this is like, I think this is like a one-time use too, but if you have a successful dive on the first 5, you can have one more dive and nobody else will have a 6th dive because you're the only player that's going to have this ability with this angler fish here. And then you don't need to worry about a number because you're the only one going for that one. So you don't have to have a 1 or anything because you'll claim it if you get it right, whether it has a shark or doesn't have a shark, of course. But that's how the angler fish basically is going to work. It gives you that extra extra dive that nobody else will have access to. But that's just, you know, a couple of the companions that definitely seemed more the kind of easy or more fascinating. This one definitely seemed more fascinating than some of the other abilities. But obviously the green sea turtle had its, you know, easy ability use as well. But basically, that's basically how companions will work. They all have these abilities that are, some are amazing, some are not as amazing, I don't think. But that's basically it for the companions variant. There's also the village chief variant, okay? So, the village chief variant, you can actually use the village chief variant if you're playing with other players, but you can also play play this game solo. If you decide to play this game solo, you're going to need the Village Chief variant. You're going to need to play with these cards here that have the Village Chief on it. And this diver here is the Village Chief diver, basically, this black one. And so basically, you're going to be playing against him. Now, he is going to act just like another player. The only difference is, you know how you have to figure out whether you have a shark on the next depth or not. You have to determine that, and when you're playing against other players, they all have to determine that too. But you see, the village chief, he's been around for a while. He knows what's going on. He knows these waters. And so he has a better understanding of which will have a shark and which won't. And so he will always be correct on whether it has a shark or doesn't have a shark. So basically, that is my biggest, obviously biggest threat, I guess you could say, playing against, obviously, the village chief, is because he's got this huge advantage, and I still have to figure out exactly which one has a shark and which one doesn't. Not only that, but I still also have to beat numbers. He's got some of these numbers here that have a 6 on them. So that means if I want to beat a 6, I'd have to, do a 5 and a 2 to make it 7, on a particular level, but of course, I don't know which one he's going to have for each level he goes down. He could go down 4 levels, but I don't know which numbers are going to be used until it's too late, until, obviously, the dive phase and all that starts. But I won't know during the program phase. I just won't know. And there's tons of cards here, so there's a lot of different, basically, combinations of numbers and bubbles. Now, when he... Also, another thing. When he does win the particular animal, so if he wins a sea turtle or a manta ray, he's still going to get the benefit of the animals, and because he's always going to be correct, he is always going to go down a certain number of numbers on the descent board. Unlike you, you're contingent on whether you get the shark right or wrong. He does not. So he is going to be moving down on the descent board really fast. That's another challenge. But once he reaches the deep waters, then you'll cover the 2 bottom numbers with these, bubble tokens, which I kind of accidentally lost. I didn't realize they were actually part of the game, so I kind of accidentally got rid of them. And so I guess I'll just have to use a penny or something to block these up to remember. But yeah, you would block these bottom 2 numbers up, and then he'll only go down a certain amount of depths when he reaches the deep waters. So once he gets to here, he'll slow down to maybe 2 or 3 at a time. But he can still obviously get points for the animals, and obviously he can easily go down 4 every round, just on at least 4, if not more, depending on what animals show up. So that's basically how the village chief is going to work if you're playing solo and you're playing against the village chief. So this game is very challenging. Even just trying to guess whether it has a shark or not, that's extremely challenging. But then if you're playing solo and you're playing against the village chief, that's even more challenging. Now, because even though it is a very challenging game, it's still a very short game too. I mean, 30 minutes doesn't take very long to play this game at all. But like I said, it's very challenging, this game for sure. But still very enjoyable, very different for sure. I really like this game. It's really interesting. It's not necessarily my favorite underwater game, but it definitely has its charms for sure. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I was good at teaching you guys how to play this particular game here called Dive. And I'll see you guys again next time. And leave a like if you guys liked this video. See you guys next time.